Hi! In this training video, we're going to look at how to record channels and how to record separate ISOs. Now, why would you want to do that? Well, most people want to record their program, and it makes a lot of sense because when you're switching your program, a lot of the editing that you would have to do in post is actually being done for you because you're live switching. But at the same time, you probably want to capture your individual cameras or laptops, whatever, in separate channels so that you can, in post-processing, do something, you know, with that the individual feeds that you've recorded. So it makes a lot of sense. So let's take a look at what is involved. Okay, what you're seeing here is the admin UI in Perl 2, and it's my program channel that's currently being recorded. You can tell by the three here that is red, it's just showing me that it's recording. And when you look at the recording tab, you can see that the recording start button is grayed out. Here you can see all the recordings that you've done on the program channel, and you could download them and delete them. Now, I also have a laptop ISO channel here too. Now, if I wanted to, I could also record that and press a button, and it would start recording that as well as a separate channel. Other training videos will go into detail about how to do things like manage your recordings, do automatic file uploads, and how to do other tasks like create multi-track recordings using recorders. But let's take a look at the different ways in Perl that you can easily start and stop recording. And the first one that I want to look at is using Epiphan Live. Now on Epiphan Live, it's a very convenient tool. I have mine actually loaded up on the iPad. You can see very easily on the dashboard where you can start and stop recording. Okay, as you can see here, my program channel is currently recording. That red button with the number beside it is telling me how long. And my other channel, the laptop ISO channel over here, is not recording. The button is grayed out. If I wanted to start, I would just press it and it would go red and start recording. And I could always just press it again and it would stop. If you were to scroll down a little bit on the dashboard, you could see here, try to make that clear. You can see here under where all the channels are listed that you could also start and stop recording individual channels that way as well. And if you go to the menu and select recordings, here you can see all the recordings that you've done on Perl. And you could download them and do various things like managing them and deleting them. Another really easy way to start and stop recording is to use the touchscreen on Perl. And let me show you just how easy and what I mean by that. From the channel view on the touchscreen, if you just tap right here in the top corner, you'll see the red light come on and start flashing, and it's telling you that you're now recording that channel. In this case, I've selected the program channel. And to stop, I would just press one more time, just like that. Now, if you just have a single channel, that's great. You can just tap the touchscreen and it's going to start recording. But when you have multiple channels, you're really going to want to do it using the one-touch feature. Let's see how that's set up using the admin UI in Perl. The first thing you want to do when you're setting up one-touch is to enable it for all the channels that you want to have included in that one-touch start all recording. Under recorder setup, I'm going to click this word change. And you can see here that single touch control has already been checked. Now that is the default. So every new channel that you create will already have the single touch applied. And here's the laptop ISO channel under the recording tab. And I'll just check and make sure. There we go. So now, if I were to start a single touch control recording, it's going to start my program channel as well as my laptop ISO. So that's how you set up single touch control. It's very simple. You'll notice also here that there are other features that you can set, like the time limit or the size of the file. And you can also set the file type, like you could choose MP4, MOV. And you could also do things like add a prefix to the file name. Now, what's nice about setting the file size is that if you're doing a lot of recording over a long period of time, you can have the files chunked into smaller pieces. The other thing you could do is click this reset button. And what the reset button does is it will stop the current recording file, but immediately start a new file and continue recording that way. That's also how the time and size limits work. When the time or the size limit is met, the Pearl will just create a new file and continue recording. One other thing I can show you that has to do with recording is to change how the One Touch is displayed. So if I just go down to the configuration tab and choose touchscreen, you can choose the default setting, which means that the One Touch screen can be accessed by touching the One Touch control icon at the bottom of Pearl 2's touch screen. Start screen, so the One Touch control displays when the system starts up, or locked, which means that the only screen that you will see on the front of Pearl 2 is going to be the One Touch control screen. So here we have the Pearl 2 touchscreen, and I wanted to show you the One Touch. The second icon right here is the One Touch icon, and as you can see, now the One Touch screen is showing. If I just tapped on that, it's going to start recording, and if I tap on it again, it's going to stop. So that's going to start and stop all of the channels that have the One Touch or the simple single touch enabled. And that's it. Thanks for watching. As you can see, there are many ways to record your channels using Pearl. You can have a simple channel, or whether you have multiple ISOs, there's an easy way to use Pearl to get the job done. So like, subscribe, and watch our many other trading videos. Bye for now.